John Lewis operates supermarkets, convenience stores, and department stores in the UK. According to Chartered Institute of Marketing,
the management process responsible for identifying, anticipating, and satisfying customer requirements profitably.
Now that we know the definition of marketing, let's apply three marketing concepts on John Lewis, mainly Porter's Five Forces, SWOT analysis, and marketing mix.
What is Porter's Five Forces? According to Porter's, we should review the competitive environment within an industry to identify the major competitive forces, because this helps us to assess their impact on an organization's present future competitive positions. Porter suggests that competition in an industry is a composite of five main competitive forces: the level of threat, the new competitors will enter the market, the threat posed by substitute products, the bargaining power of buyers, and the bargaining power of suppliers. This in turn affect the fifth force, the intensity of rivalry between the current competitors. Porter called these variables the five forces of competitive industry analysis.
Now let's apply Porter's five forces to John Lewis. The first force is the threat of new entrants, which is low. The second one is the threat of substitutes, which is medium. The third one is bargaining power of buyers, which is again mediums. The fourth one is bargaining power of supplier, which is low. And the last one is intensity of competitive rivalry, which is high.
So what is SWOT analysis? It is a framework comprises of series of checklists presented as internal strengths and weaknesses and external opportunities or threats. Strengths and weaknesses related to the internal resources and capabilities of the organization as perceived by the customers.
Okay, now let's apply SWOT analysis on John Lewis. So let's look at the strengths. John Lewis has strong operational network in United Kingdom. Coming to the weaknesses, it has currently for the fiscal year 2022 low liquidity. And looking at the opportunities, given that John Lewis has large number of products in their markets, in their retail stores, there's a big opportunity for online e-commerce for John Lewis in the future, as the e-commerce market is growing every year. And looking at the threats, there are intense competition in the market with new brands coming in and other brands diversifying their product range, which is giving intense competition to John Lewis.
Okay, so Neil Borden originally developed the marketing mix concept at Harvard University in 1950s. Originally, marketing mix had 12 items of marketing procedures and policies to produce. This list was simplified and amended by Eugen in 1960 to the more memorable 4 P's, which is even used until today. The marketing mix definition. The framework comprises a series of checklists presented as internal strengths and weaknesses and external opportunities or threats. Strengths and weaknesses relate to the internal resources and capabilities of the organization as perceived by customers.
What are you reading?
Sherlock.
Complete your marketing mix.
Oh. Okay. So let's apply marketing mix framework on John Lewis. So let's look at the first P, which is product. John Lewis has large number of products and different varieties of brands. The second P is place. So John Lewis has 34 stores and 329 Waitrose stores and online presence as well. The third P is price. John Lewis has premium price, but it follows fair price policy. And the last P is promotion. John Lewis follows innovative promotional ideas like for the festive season and Christmas season.
In the conclusion, I would like to say that John Lewis stands as a stalwart in the retail industry, leveraging its established brand commitment to quality and unique employee-owned business model. The company's emphasis on differentiation through private label brands and never knowingly undersell policy has fortified its premium market position. However, challenges like dependence in the UK market and ever-evolving retail landscape necessitates strategic adaptations. Now, finally, some implications for John Lewis. John Lewis should fortify its online presence, embracing digital trends, and consider diversification into new product categories to expand its market reach. Accelerating sustainable practices aligns with the rising demands for ethical business. Enhancing brand image, the company's future success hinges on agile decision-making, continuous innovation, and a customer-centric approach, ensuring it not only meets but anticipates changing consumer preferences.